guys, this is Tim at Tech Paintball again. I'm here today with my X7 Phenom, and today we're going to be covering a few troubleshooting techniques that you may be encountering with your MRT Phenom bolt. As I said, I've got my X7 Phenom here, and some of the problems that people are encountering actually have to do with the cyclone feed. The bolt itself is so light that it is actually moving past the LAN, which controls the input going to the cyclone feed, and may or may not causing you to have problems with the paddles actuating. So today I'm going to take you through not only the install of our new Phase 5 fitting, but also trimming the spring so that you will get a consistent actuation every time of the cyclone feed paddles. So we're going to jump right into it. I've got the stock plastic fitting installed so that you guys can see or not see whatever your case may be, if you're actually experiencing some of the same symptoms that some of the other people have seen. Again, stock, with the exception of I do have squishy paddles installed. That's just something I do for testing in case I encounter brittle paint. But otherwise, the cyclone feed itself is completely stock. So I'm going to go ahead and just take a couple pulls on the trigger, dry fire a few times, and you should see paddles will slightly, they want to jump, but they will not quite actuate. I'll fire it a few more times so you can see if you're experiencing the same thing. And if that's the case, no worries, we've got a fix. I'm going to go ahead and remove my air source. And also going to remove the barrel so that we can work on this and you guys can see everything in frame. All right, guys, where we're going to start is we need to remove the three retaining pins that hold the gun together and hold the valve in place. So we're going to go ahead and remove those. We're more or less going back to square one with our install. If you watched the video prior to this, go ahead and remove that last one. Pop off our back cap, remove our grip frame. And all we need to do is remove the retaining pin and pull out our fitting. Now, you guys can see again, this is the black stock fitting. We're going to be replacing it with our Phase 5 fitting, which I believe we did show in the install video. It's a stainless steel fitting, much larger orifice for air to travel through. It is not going to use any more air, it is just going to allow for less restriction in terms of the volume of air that's coming through it. It's not going to change that volume of air. It's just allowing that air to flow more freely. Okay, so all we're going to do, and I probably should do this right side up so you guys can see it. Take that off. Take my fitting. Slide the valve forward. And just pop it in. Slide it forward. And we're going to go ahead and go right back and put in our pins and reassemble the gun. Now, some of you guys may or may not encounter issues after we've reassembled the gun with the air fitting. If that's the case, I'm going to show you the next step, and that is how to trim your spring correctly in the cyclone feed itself. It does not mean you have to have our upgrades nor anyone else's upgrades for the cyclone feed, but it is something that may be necessary to get the bolt to function properly and get in conjunction with the cyclone feed paddles. So there we go. We are reassembled. We've got our new fitting installed. And I'm going to go ahead and reattach our air source. I've got a Ninja 6845, really nice consistent tank. And go ahead and put the barrel on just so that we all don't go deaf. All right, and we are ready to fire. And you guys should see the paddles move pretty consistently. I'm going to fire about 20 shots, and we'll see if they rotate. Okay, well, I lied. That's about 30 shots. But you can see that they consistently moved. We did not get any misfires or hiccups in the actuation of the paddles themselves. And this gun for all intents and purposes, is working correctly. It is loading correctly. We took the same setup out to the field over the weekend, put about two cases through it, worked like a champ. So if you're encountering any more issues beyond that, I'm going to show you the next step in the process. So if you've installed the bolt and you're still having issues, there's another fix that you can try, and it should remedy anything else that's out there. I would say maybe no more than 5% of people are going to have to do this, but you're going to pull off your quick, or in this case, not the quick exhaust piston housing, your just plain piston stock piston housing, and you've got your piston rod, the spring, and the little spring guide that sits at the base, closest to the ratchet. What you're going to need to do is you're going to need to trim the spring on the piston rod. It's not going to hurt anything. It actually is just going to require less force to actuate. And what that's going to allow the bolt to do, or the Phenom bolt to do, is run on the amount of air that it's expelling from that land area from within the valve. So what you're going to do is you're actually going to trim 2 to 3 rotations. I hope you guys can see that. On this end, from the spring, you can actually do it while it's still installed. All you're going to need to use is a regular old pair of snips, okay? It will actually probably be a little bit easier if you have a second pair of hands, someone helping you. It's always good to use the buddy system. But once you've done that, and I'm going to set this over to the side, just want to be able to show you guys what the difference in size is. This is a spring that I have not trimmed. This is one that we have. This was actually used in a gun where we were trying to troubleshoot the issues. We did find that with this many rotations cut off, it worked beautifully, no problems, no issues in terms of skipping shots or not rotating at all, or just barely jumping or twitching. You're probably going to see a similar situation with your gun. If you have to trim the spring, you're probably going to get about 2 to 3 rotations trimmed off. But I just wanted you guys to have a point of reference for the spring size, and there it is. Well, I hope that covers it for everybody. If you're still having issues, please, please do not hesitate to contact us. We can be emailed at support@techpaintball.com, or you can hit me personally with an email at tim@techpaintball.com, and I will be happy to walk you through any issues you might be having and get those remedied immediately. Please visit www.techpaintball.com for more information about our parts and what we do. If you need to contact us by phone, please call us at 901-405-1848. Again, this is Tim at Tech Paintball, guys, and thanks for watching. And what you're going to see is, in terms of, I've got two springs here that are trimmed already. Here's the stock one. Here's the one that we've trimmed down. And you can see about, get them level there, about 2 to 3 rotations have been trimmed off those. We did use this one in a Phenom that was giving us a few more problems. It was almost there, and it would actually cycle and actuate pretty much on every shot, but every once in a while it would skip. After doing this, shot consistent every time, there was always a ball ready. So anyway, there's your two spring lengths. Pretty easy there. If you guys have any questions at all, please do not hesitate to ask. You can reach us at www.techpaintball.com, the website. Our email is support@techpaintball.com. You can email me directly at tim@techpaintball.com. Again, please do not hesitate to ask. If you have any issues, please contact us directly. Again, this is Tim at Tech Paintball, guys. Thanks for watching.